Hi, welcome. This will be a short video about analog mixing consoles and their relation to DAWs, so digital audio workstations, or DAWs as they are called. And this is part of Cubase training that I provide, and you can find further information on my website, studio.skippyweb.eu. But let's get started and dive into it. So mixing consoles and DAWs, digital audio working stations. What you see here is an analog mixing console, and this is one of the industry standards, the SSL 4000E, so from solid state logic. And you see many knobs and metering and faders. But as we will see, many of these knobs are the same because they just represent one channel, and a mixer like this has many channels. Now, what you also see, and this is in another studio that I took from the internet, but on the right side, you see all this outboard gear, as it is called. And these racks contain all kinds of audio processors, and that includes, for example, compressors, but also reverbs and delays to add echo, for example. And I also will come back to that and show you how that is done nowadays inside a DAW. But there are also much simpler mixers, like the one that you see here in the slide. The Soundcraft, these are generally very cheap, so everyone can afford them. Here you see also in what is called a digital peak meter, so you can monitor the level of your audio. And these types of meters you also find back in the DAW. Okay, so one of the things that you see is that there are many channels that all have the same anatomy. So they have the same knobs and faders. So if you understand one of these strips, then you already understand large part of a mixing console. Now, first of all, if you go to the upper right part of these mixers, this mixer in particular, then you find output. So for example, here you have your main output, which is basically your stereo mix of everything that you are mixing, and you can connect this to an amplifier and your speakers. But you have also a separate what is called monitor out, and you have outputs that you can connect, for example, to your tape recorder, and there are mono outputs, etc. So in general, you have different types of outputs that serve different functions, like listening to your mix and making for monitoring or making a recording. Now, then we can have a look at these channels. And what you see here is one mono channel. And on this mixer, we have 8 mono channels, as you see, and they are all the same. And so what we can do is to have different inputs connected to each of these channels. So for example, on the first channel we can have a microphone, then on the third channel we can have a synthesizer, and etc. And then the output is connected to our speakers, and we can make a recording on a tape desk if you want. And what you see that you have these types of connectors, which are called XLR, and also these jack connectors. So you see them also here. So this is an XLR, this is a jack, but that is for now not very important. But microphones you normally connect through an XLR cable, and things like synthesizers and other instruments, they normally have a jack cable. The first knob, so I will skip the insert. I will come back to this, what it is. But the first knob that you see is the gain knob, and this is just to adjust the amount of level of your input signal. So if you have a very low level, then you can increase the gain a bit, to have it in a similar at a similar level of all the other inputs. Now then we have here four knobs that make up the equalizer, and that is for adjusting the frequencies of your input. If you have a high shelving filter, a low shelving filter, and a band pass filter in this case, where you can select a specific frequency and then increase or decrease the level of that frequency. And that is also shown here in the in these figures. So you have this high and low shelving part, so that were the high filter and low filter, as they are called here on the mixer. And that allows you to cut away higher frequencies or lower frequencies. And sometimes these look like a high cut filter like this. So instead of a shelf, you have a high cut. And instead of a lower shelf, you can have a low cut. And these are also sometimes called high pass and low pass, because low pass, and because it passes the lower frequencies and cut away the higher frequencies. So that is what the high shelf and low shelves are doing. So you can cut away the lower bass frequencies, or you can boost them, you can also increase them. And then we have also a bandpass filter, and there normally you can set the frequency and the width of the curve, which is called the Q factor, and the amount of boosting or gaining that you want to do. So that is basically what this equalizer is doing. Now, then we have two knobs here that are called auxiliary 1 and auxiliary 2. And this is to send signal to external outboard gear, or to make submixes. And I also will come back to that in a minute. But let's first continue. Then we have the panning knob here, and that is to pan your signal to the left or to the right side of your mix, to the left or right speaker, so to say. Now then we have here, we have two knobs, which is called the pre-fader listening and the mute, and often you will also find a solo button. Now I'm not going into the pre-fader listening, but mute, you just mute the channel, so you don't hear the audio that is coming in anymore. And if you would have a solo button, you can press it, and then you would only hear that particular channel. And then finally you have the volume fader that allows you to change the level of the channel. You should now have a basic understanding of a channel of a mixer. So it is a mono input, generally, to which you can attach a microphone or an instrument like a synthesizer or bass guitar or a guitar or maybe all the microphones of a drum kit. And then that specific signal will flow through the channel strip, and then you have the opportunity to, for example, increase the gain, do equalization to change frequencies, and then finally it will get to the fader where you can adjust the volume of that specific channel. Now, I did skip the auxiliaries, I mentioned them, and I also skipped the insert jacket. Now, and I'm going to explain these now, and these are a little bit more complex, maybe to understand if you first see them. But once you understand how the signal flows through a mixer, then you should also now have no problems in understanding these, so the auxiliaries and the inserts. And then you will also see how that will work in the DAW once you get started with that. Okay, so let's have a look at the auxiliaries and the stereo mix. So, and that is here indicated by the green lines. So the channel is basically a horizontal flow of the signal that comes in, so a microphone, for example. But on a mixer you can also have horizontal flows. So going from left to right, so indicated by the green arrows. And that has several applications, as I will show. But this horizontal signal flow, this is often called a mixed bus. And a mixed bus sums together the signals that come in from different channels on your mixer. And you can decide which of these channels you want to sum on a particular mixed bus. These auxiliaries are called sends in Cubase. And what I have called here a stereo mix is called stereo out in Cubase. So now let's have a look at it in a little bit more detail. So we have an input channel, let's say the first channel on our mixer. So we attach a microphone to it, and then that microphone signal will flow through the channel until it reaches the fader. So this is basically our vertical flow that we have on the mixer. So if you go back, this is the flow that we are now talking about. So you have an input and then it flows all the way to the fader. And then once we are at the fader, then we have, say, a horizontal flow. Because now, what we have to route the signal to the main mix bus. And the main mix bus is what you connect to your speakers. And then you have a left channel, so mix left as it is called here. And you have a right channel. So you have a stereo mix bus. And every channel is connected to this mix bus. So if you have multiple channels, so these are mixed together on this mix bus, and that is then sent out to your speakers. So this is called your mix bus. Now the auxiliaries is just a rerouting of your signal. So there is a branch in the signal flow, and then with the auxiliary knob you determine how much of your signal you want to get to one of these mix buses, and which I have called here auxiliary one bus. But this is a mix bus. It's also a horizontal signal flow. So if you go back, so that is basically this green line that is here. And that has some very nice applications. So again, so the mix bus, main mix bus, so the stereo bus will go to your speakers. But the auxiliary out, yeah, you can do something else with this. For example, put that on your headphone. And so if you don't want to hear the instruments, but only want to hear the microphone on channel 1, yeah, then you only put with the auxiliary knob some of the signal on the mix bus, auxiliary 1 bus, and then that signal will go, you can connect to your headphone. And if you put the auxiliary knob to 0 for all other channels, so you will not hear on your headphone any of the other instruments. So this is just to complete the picture. So now we have two input channels. So they flow to the main stereo bus, which is then connected to your speakers. But through this rerouting, by branching it off, it can also go to the auxiliary one signal flow and go to the auxiliary one bus, or the mix bus one. And then if you do that, so now you have input channel one, a microphone, and input channel two, a guitar on your headphone. So this is how the auxiliaries work. Okay, let's go back. So, and that is also what we have seen on the mixer. So we have an output to go to our speakers in the end. But here you also see two mono outputs for your auxiliary 1 mix bus and your auxiliary 2 mix bus. And this is, for example, auxiliary one. You could decide to connect to your headphone, and then with the auxiliary one knobs, you can decide which instruments, which channels you want to hear on your headphone. Again, a little bit different look. So we have a channel comes in, and it is routed to the main stereo bus always. So that these are these two faders. So that is for the overall level of your mix. And this internally is routed to these two outputs, which you connect to your speakers. And so the speakers are called, this stereo mix bus is called stereo out. And that is also connected to your speakers by connecting your computer to your speakers. And then if we have a look at the auxiliary one, then in this example, channel 1 and channel 5, I have now connected and rerouted to the sub-mix bus, and the auxiliary 1 bus. So all the other aux knobs are set to 0, except for 1 and 5. This signal will go over the green line, and internally is rerouted to the output, auxiliary 1, and that's where you can connect whatever you want, for example your headphone. But you can not only connect your headphone, no, that wouldn't be fun. You can also connect, for example, an effects processor that puts reverb or delay, echoes on your signal. So in that case, for example, if you have channel 1, which would be a microphone, you can put that on your mix bus, and then it is internally routed to the auxiliary 1 output. You can connect that output to this device. So this is outboard gear, an audio processor that can put reverb or delay on your signal. And then the output of this you can feed back on, let's say, on channel 8 of your mixer. So now you see what happens is that you have your dry signal without reverb on fader 1. And the reverb is on fader 8. So now you can mix them together and you can say, well, I want to have more or less reverb on my vocals. And because it is now the auxiliary one goes to an effects processor, the mix bus is often called an effects bus. Okay, now another thing that I skipped, that were these insert jackets. And there you can do more or less the same thing. So also in your DAW Cubase you will find insert slots, and that are a substitute for these connections that you see here. And an insert basically interrupts the channel. So if you put in a cable like this, on one side you have a stereo connector, tip, ring, sleeve, and on the other side you have two mono jack connectors, and you see this one is ring, this one is the tip. So now what happens if you put this stereo part in the connector, then everything that comes in will first flow through the cable, so it will go out over the tip and will return on the ring. So again, you can then connect an audio processor to this cable to do some processing before it goes to the gain, the equalizer, the auxiliaries and the final fader. Okay, so how would that work? So you take that cable, you put the stereo jack here, then the tip part is put to the input of your effect processor. And the ring part is then connected to the output of this device. And then you have closed the loop. So what then happens is you will have a signal coming in, a microphone. It sees that there is a connector attached, a plug inserted. So then it will first reroute the signal through the effect processor, go back. And then it will pass to the gain, equalizer, auxiliary panning and the faders. And then you can basically do the same. So if you do set the reverb here, then you can put reverb on your vocals. So you get the microphone in with the vocals. then it will go through the reverb, and the vocals with reverb are returned and then continue down the signal, down the channel. Now the difference with the auxiliaries is now that you don't have a separate channel for your reverb and for your dry vocal. So that is now all on this channel. So you cannot balance reverb and your dry vocal on the mixer. So you have to do that on the processing device itself. So that is not necessarily a problem, but I just indicate that this is a difference between using the inserts and the auxiliaries. So the next thing that I need to explain is the sound card. So every computer, and so your laptop or a desktop computer, will have an internal sound card. And you can use that to, for example, connect a microphone for doing recording and to connect speakers to listen to whatever you are playing on your computer. Okay, and this is an example of a very simple sound card that you find in most desktop computers. And you can connect a microphone to it, you can connect your speakers and then do whatever you want to do. But these are not a very good quality and also not really suited if you are going to get serious with DAWs. So in that case, I would recommend to buy an external sound card. And this is just one example from Focusrite. So this one has 8 inputs and 9 to 16 outputs. And the sound card you can connect to your speakers. Now, and what you then do is by using a simple USB cable, you can connect it to your computer and then you can use it together with your DAW, Cubase or another one. And in DAW, so that is nothing more than software that allows you to do recording, editing of your audio and also producing audio files. Now then a few words about the outboard gear again. So this is another nice picture of a studio, again with a large mixing console. And now you understand more or less that these are all the channels. And these also have auxiliary knobs, so you can send the signal to all this equipment that you see here in these racks. And this is equipment for doing equalization, for compression, for audio processing, and so for example reverb and delays, etc. But nowadays we have so-called plugins, and that are software programs that you can use with your DAW and have the same functionality as these hardware devices. So for example, here you see again a Lexicon delay again, so for putting reverb and echo on your signal. And this is the software alternative that you can use inside your DAW. Now, there is another type of plugin, and these are called virtual instruments, VSTIs also, and this is one example. This is from East West Symphonic Orchestra. And what they have done in this case is that they have sampled violins, contrabasses, flutes, and so all these orchestra instruments. And then by playing on this piano keyboard that you see here, you can trigger the sounds of the all the instruments that they have recorded. Now, and this allows you to make music inside your DAW using all the sounds that are provided by these virtual instruments. So this kind of concludes this introduction video. So you will be using a DAW where you can do the mixing of all the audio files you have, and these audio files you can either import directly in your DAW, so if you have downloaded them from, for example, from an internet site. And then once you are satisfied with your mix, you can export your mix to an audio file, for example, an MP3. And of course, if you have, you can connect your laptop, and you should connect your laptop to speakers, and perhaps you have an external sound card or external effects processors, so you can all connect that to your DAW. So this is kind of how this works. So I hope that you now understand the basic principles of a mixer, and you will see later on how this now corresponds to a DAW. Okay, have fun.